Folks, Scrambled O checking in. All right, guys, down here at the camp today, and I'm gonna be doing a little bit of breakfast cooking today. I got an idea. I'm sure it's been done before, but this is what we call a bacon-weaved breakfast. A bacon-weaved breakfast taco. So as you can probably tell by the name, I'm gonna take a bunch of pieces of bacon, weave them together in some type of a blanket, cook them up, and then use that to form the shell of a taco. To fill the taco, I'm gonna put some scrambled eggs, some cheese, some peppers, some salsa, all kinds of good stuff. So join me here out in the woods while I gather some wood, rearrange the fire pit, and get to cooking. Hope you guys enjoy. All right, first things first, I gotta gather some firewood up. We had a big windstorm in the area a couple weeks ago, so there should be plenty of dead standing wood that's recently fallen down. Hopefully I can find something that's not too wham. Here's a big down tree that's looking pretty nice. All right, so for this particular breakfast, I really have to do a good job of gathering a lot of firewood. Usually I get lazy and I don't gather enough, but today I want to cook over coals. I've got this big, I don't know what it is. It's not cast iron, but it's like a steel griddle, reversible. You can flip it over and it's got little grill marks. The other side's flat, like a regular griddle. But I'm gonna be using that to cook up the bacon weave today. Point I'm trying to drive home is I gotta gather a lot of wood to cook over coals. A lot easier to regulate the temperature over coals. And the bacon weave's gonna take quite a while to cook, so I gotta do it slow and steady. So let's gather some more firewood. Ah! All right, guys, doing good so far. Got some little twigmans, got some bigger stuff, some small stuff, medium stuff, and I've got a little base built up for my fire. If you guys will notice, you see what I did with the rock pit is I put together more of a little valley. So I get my fire going down here, and then I can set my griddle on top of the rocks. So yeah, pretty good little setup. Got a little bit of a knot. Got a little knot right there. It's making it not want to go very smooth. Alright guys, campfire is going. Time to prepare the bacon. I've never done this before, but it's fairly straightforward and simple. You just take a bunch of pieces of bacon, wrap them and weave them together to create some sort of a little bacon blanket.
Alright, so I got one pack of thick cut bacon, and it really shouldn't be that difficult. You just want to pack the bacon in like a grid layout and weave it all together. So let's see, how would I do this? Alternating, which means I gotta peel back every other one like that. Put that on top of that like that. Then you peel back these ones. Hopefully you don't drop the bacon. And you put another piece. Can you guys see that? Put this other piece up in there like that. Tuck it tight. Tuck, tuck. You start to see a little bit of a weave, a little bit of a pattern, don't you? All right, it's looking pretty good. Not gonna lie, it says over top because underneath, let me just pull these up. So the premise of this breakfast taco is that you're making the shell of the taco out of this bacon weave. I thought, what's better than just bacon? I thought, maybe if I made something out of bacon that's not traditionally made out of bacon, I could raise the epicness of it. So like, for instance, tacos are the bomb. Breakfast tacos are amazing. Can we up the ante? Can we do something crazier? Like a bacon weave breakfast taco. Look at that bacon weave, boy. We can't even see it. So there it is, a 5x5 bacon weave. I'm gonna kind of press it all together because this bacon is still, I mean, it's fresh bacon. It's brand new, so it's sticky. My hope is that maybe if I press it together, help it hold together while it cooks. Let's get some more sunlight out here, boy. Look at that bacon weave, boy. Smell that smoke on it. Smell the hickory, boy. Ooh, yeah. All right, that's it, boys. Bacon weave is done. I'm gonna try to cook this very slow. And hopefully, this little ringy around the griddle catches some of the grease. Fire smoldering. See, this is gonna be the height, right here, of the griddle. So, I really want it to cook slow, so I still need to wait a little longer for this fire to cool down. All right, well, while the fire cooks down, at least I can heat up some water for some coffee, and I can prep my peppers, my tomatoes, crack my eggs and stuff for the breakfast taco. Rarely ever get any nice and peace and quiet out here. You guys know about the Joe plane. What do you know about the O train? There's a train track probably like 2 miles from here. Every 30 minutes. Brutal. Kills the moment. The serenity is gone. I don't like it. I wish I could just keep it nice and peaceful out here and hear the sounds of nature, but you guys will hear trains going by. It's like, man, come on. But this is all I got, so I'm gonna do what I can with what I got. I mean, coffee time. Coffee time. Coffee hack. Hack. Don't make the coffee too spicy or else you'll have to poop in the woods. Hack. So the fire pit seems to be working pretty good. I have heard a couple of little explosions, which means my rocks are holding moisture still, which means they are exploding due to the moisture heating up and basically boiling inside the rock. I like this fire pit though, man. I got a little flat area over here I can keep stuff. I got my secondary flat area down there. Like that, my little secondary flat rock hold stuff. pretty awesome, actually. I like it.
All right, while I sit and wait for the fire to cook down, I can prep my veggies. I'm gonna be putting a green pepper inside my breakfast taco. Just add a little color, give it a little taste, a little secondary flavors. You gotta layer your flavors. You gotta layer your textures. Anybody who's a master chef like Scrambled O knows this. You need to have a balance on the flavor spectrum. Know what I mean? On the real, I really am not good at cooking at all. So coming out here in the woods and just messing around and trying to cook stuff is where it's at. This is not a tutorial, boys and girls. All right, so we're gonna get this green bell pepper, dice it all up. I feel like green peppers will be good on this thing. Don't you put green peppers in omelets and stuff and salsa? So I brought salsa out, green peppers, cheddar cheese, 2 eggs, a whole pack of bacon to make the actual shell. So yeah, hopefully that's a good flavor combination. I've never tried this before. I can't imagine it wouldn't be amazing though. Bacon? Full freaking taco shell made of bacon? So this might kick off a little series where I try to give myself a heart attack. All right, next up, let's dice up a little tomato. Don't need much. I even forgot that. Got me a, what do you call them things? Armadillo? Avocado. We actually might just be making a little guac. Here we go. Get a little of that. Right there. Put some of this tomato in it. Kind of mash it up a little bit. Oh, heck yeah. Oh, yeah. Heck yeah. Still real, real hot. Might need to knock this down a little bit. Spread the coals out a little. Yep. Patience is a virtue. I need to wait a little longer.
All right, so the premise of the bacon wrap is to cook it, not till it's crispy. You know how hard shell tacos always crispy. You wanna cook it till it's cooked, but still soft. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to hang, kind of droop the bacon over a stick over the fire to finalize it. That way it'll form into that taco shell shape that I'm looking for. And yeah, hopefully it works. It could fall apart, fall in the fire. I wouldn't be surprised by that whatsoever. So yeah, I just want to give you guys a little insight as to how this is supposed to work, because Lord knows what is actually going to happen. It'll probably be completely different. As long as I don't lose any bacon during the filming of this video, that's all that matters. I'm going to just pick up camp while I'm sitting here waiting. Pick up camp, organize my tools. Show you guys what the heck's going on in the camp kitchen right now. All right, so I got my salsa, cheddar cheese. This is my coffee. A little creamer, because I'm a sissy.
guacamole, hashtag avocado, diced tomato, green pepper, eggs, and peep this.
This is from Solo Siberia. He hooked me up almost been probably a year, and I just haven't done that many videos. You guys know that. So today will be my first time christening the Kuksa. Look how freaking awesome that is, man.
Beautiful. Christen that with my first cup of coffee today.
Put a little hot water in there, swish it around. Trying to acclimate the Kuksa. I do not want to put super hot water in it. Have it not be used to that first time pouring in. I just am trying to slowly heat this thing up. Like so.
Cheers, guys. Take another look at that. He does beautiful work. Check him out. He's on Instagram. Boy, oh boy. The craftsmanship, man. I got to get a woodworking setup so I can start making these. Beautiful. Amazing.
Cheers. Clink.
That's good. Real good. Only thing I wish is they were huge. Got like a huge Kuksa. Because this right here, it's only enough coffee to get me a little crazy. Not enough to make me go full out bizarro scrambled.
Dang, that's good.
Little. All right, time to throw this bacon wrap on the fire, get to the main course. Got everything diced up. Time to just cook the bacon.
All right, this is working earlier. There we go.
This could be a colossal mistake. The entire weight of the bacon is just sitting on that little corner right there. Pretty cool, huh? Coals. And if it's not heating up quick enough, if I've waited too long, I can always throw more stuff in. You know, I was thoughtful. I got a little extra. So, yeah, it's cool, huh? I do need to build this rock platform up a little bit better to make this more stable. That is not engineered particularly well. Oh my gosh. Yeah, I'm gonna have to adjust this a little bit.
All right, I just used my brain. And the bacon is as wide as this little cavern, this little channel. So I can turn it sideways like this, no problem. It should cook all the bacon as I need it to. So I'm thinking this is probably gonna take 30 plus minutes to cook. Yeah, what I'll do probably is just kind of walk the area and pick up all this deadfall. Cut up, get a good firewood pile for the next time I come out and do a video. Keep checking on the bacon. Make sure it's cooking all right.
I'm gonna try to put these little grills on top to hopefully help flatten it out a little bit. You know how bacon is, it likes to get all ripply.
like bacon. It's like bacon jail. Locked up. Doing hard time. So typically you're supposed to do this in a house and cook in an oven, but I really didn't know how to put together a rock oven today. So this is gonna be the first attempt at this. Hopefully it works. Hopefully it works. Flipping it is gonna be the hard part. No idea how to do that. No idea. If you have any good ideas, send me telepathy at Scrambledo. Send me telepathy powers. Send me some intelligence. Thank you.
See, the thing about bacon I don't understand is why does it have to be unhealthy? You know, it tastes like heaven. It shouldn't make you die and go to heaven. Why has it got to be unhealthy? Things aren't fair. Got this side much higher than that side by like 2 or 3 inches. So all that bacon grease drippies off right there into the rock. So little baby squirrels are going to be feasting on that bacon grease tonight. www.feedthesquirrels.com.
Joe Plain?
Help! I'm stranded! I'm surviving off bacon weave breakfast tacos! It's cold this morning, man. It was like, it was probably 25 degrees, which is -5 in Canada, maybe. It was cold. Now it's warming up. Sun got me blasted. I might get a tan out here today. All right, I think the bacon's cooked as much as I want it to cook on this first run of cooking this one side. So I'm gonna try to pull it off, try to flip it, try to figure something out so I can cook the other side now. Don't have a spatula. So what I'm gonna try to do is use the little grill to get up underneath. It's actually going pretty good. Come on, bacon weave, don't fall apart on me now. So I think I should be able to just slide the grill under it, flippy floppity it. Whoa! Not bad. If you didn't know any better, you'd think I knew what I was doing. See, the good thing about doing this in the oven is that the heat's all around it, so it would actually cook these overlapped areas much better than what I'm doing. But I'm gonna cook it nice and slow. The second half is gonna cook nice and slow so that those areas will cook. But that is perfect. It's not crispy. I mean, it is crispy, but it's not inflexible. Right now, I still have the ability to form it over my branch, to drape it, to get the actual shape I want. Bacon's getting close, guys. So I'm gonna go get a little bit of grease. Go get a little bit of grease off the bacon and line my pan with it to cook my eggs. There's nothing better than bacon grease to oil a frying pan. So for this particular meal, I'm gonna take my two eggs and scramble them. The eggs are gonna kind of be like the ground beef. If you're making a normal taco, the meat goes in the bottom of the taco shell, and that's what I'm gonna do with these eggs.
Good shot. Right in the fire pit. Oops, missed that one. I could just use a stick. I'm also going to sprinkle a little cheese. Cheese is going to go on the top of the taco, but also I want some in the egg. Oh, this is going to be so good. At this point, I'm kind of trying to figure out, I'm kind of trying to figure out how to form the bacon into a taco shell-like shape. So my thought was, just drape it over a stick and hope it stays together. Like that. Maybe. There's the bacon wrap. Dude, I got one piece of bacon that's hanging on by a thread. This is not good. Not good. All right, got the eggs on, put the peppers in it, cook this up while the bacon finishes up. Pretty soon we're gonna be eating a taco, guys. See that bacon? That's the edge bacon, the perimeter bacon. It's come untucked from right there. So we're gonna have some work. We got our work cut out for us, that's all I'm trying to say. We're gonna have to craft this thing back into a nice, nice, pretty looking taco. Oh, the makes smell good. Oh, yes. Those eggs are delicious smelling. Oh, yeah, baby. Almost done, boys, almost done. I can tell you one thing, that my tummy grumbling. You can hear it from your side of the computer screen. Pretty dang good. Do a little bit of work on it real quick. All right, guys, this bacon wrap turned out real nice. Let's see if I can show you guys. Oh boy. So here's the last piece right here is not wanting to hold on very well. Maybe it's because I don't have it weaved right. There we go. That goes there. That goes there. Yeah, I'm sure this is much easier with an oven. But man, that looks good. All right, let's get to making this taco. Take me some eggs. Drop these eggs right down there in the bottom. See that? Let's get you zoomed in. In case you can see that bit. Oh man, tell me that's not looking amazing. All right, hit it with some of this green slime. Oh man, sprinkle on some tomato. Top it off with some cheese. And then hit it with a little bit. We should probably get a little bit better camera angle, huh? And then hit it with a teensy bit of salsa. Voila. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. All right, boys. First bite of this monster bacon wrap taco. First bite. So many flavors. First thing you taste is the bacon and the salsa. Great combo. Man, that's good. Bacon and the salsa come together to create the little blanket of flavor. And then inside it, you feel the mushy guacamole avocado mixture. I mean, you get a little crunch through the green pepper, and then that egg hits you last. The egg with that cheese. Man, that smells good. Bite number two, I'm not messing around. Man, that's good. Look at it. Look at that breakfast taco. Perfect. All right, back to eating. Guys, I'll tell you, the only word I can think of to explain how good this is unbelievable. I'll tell you what, those green peppers, oh man, that's so good. That's amazing. You have no idea unless you try this how good it is. Bacon,
add in eggs and cheese, that pepper. I'm not kidding. I could eat this every day. The salsa. Dang, that was a good bite. Oh my God, man. I wish you guys could have a bite of this. Open up. I'm not kidding. This is the top three best things I've ever cooked outside. Oh my God. Not exaggerating at all. You guys know. You guys could tell. Bacon, eggs, peppers. God, man. Avocado and salsa. Oh my goodness. Sorry if I'm chewing like a pig, but this is freaking amazing. Top three foods I've ever cooked in the woods. Bacon wrapped cinnamon rolls, bacon fried apple with cinnamon, and this. Oh my God, man. You guys are gonna have to sit and watch me eat this whole dang thing. Guys, you can't even fathom how amazing this is. Imagine everything I've already told you about how good this is with a smoky a smoky taste. Look at them slimy fingers, boy. I hate that when people have their slimy fingers in the pictures. Well, can't help it. Oh my God. As if this moment couldn't get any better. The most beautiful birds I've ever seen. It's literally 10 feet from my camp. Oh my God. That is the most amazing bird I've ever seen. It was like purple and blue. There's another one. It looks small, like a little robin or sparrow, but it's got like a dark purplish blue wings and like an orangish red chest. My camera won't zoom in that far, so I can't show you guys. But man, is that a beautiful bird. There's two of them, one right there, and then one flew up right to this tree next to my campsite. That bird probably smell what I got cooking over here. Sorry if I'm a little animated, a little hyper. I'm trying to explain to you guys this flavor is impossible to do. This is so good. Oh my God. It's almost too much bacon, like too rich. The bird just took a little poop. First time I've ever seen that happen. Down to my last slimy little bite. Now that was a bacon bite right there. Beautiful. I don't know if the camera's picking up all the little facets on this thing. Did you see that? The bird flew right into my camp. Tell me that got on camera. The bird literally flew in here. Oh my God, I can't wait to see if I get that on film. What is going on today? The whole woods knows what's going on. I'm cooking this bacon-wrapped breakfast taco, and the whole freaking ecosystem's all messed up right now. Got worms doing the moonwalk, the moon inch, the birds out here singing, chirping, flying under the base camp. That's it. That's all she wrote. Little campfire going. Beautiful little rock pit. Beautiful little campsite. Beautiful day. blue skies, woodpeckers, little blue chest bird, I don't know what it is, bacon wrapped taco, the methods to cooking the taco worked just fine. The key, as I said earlier in the video, was to take it slow. I probably been out here 3 hours. 3 hours to cook that, and it was worth it, no doubt about it. Oh my goodness. The fire pit's coming together. Real nice for cooking. Really, really nice. Next thing I'm gonna do is right here is a tree. Is I'm gonna dig a hole and bury a little post. I got one right over there, dead piece of wood. Bury a post, and then I'm gonna take a nice flat piece of wood and screw it, nail it into that post, and then prop it against this tree so I have a nice flat tabletop to set my stuff on. It'll give me like a little 1 by 3 foot tabletop surface for me to prep food on. I mean, my chair's right here already, so I'll have a little work surface, a little desk, table, whatever you want to call it. That would help tremendously because it's hard to find good flat surfaces out here. Last time I was out here, I saw a red-tailed hawk destroying, I think it was a squirrel. This little plot really does have a lot of different birds. Got the red-tailed hawks, several different kinds of hawks. Got a couple different kinds of owls out here. Rabbits. Did I tell you guys I've seen a red fox out here? It was unbelievable, man. This is like a little slice of heaven out here. Only thing I wish is that our creek had some more action to it, you know? We've got two creeks, but they dry out most of the year, and the only time they really run with water is after a big rainstorm. That means the water is just pure mud water, so it's not very pretty. But we've got a nice variety of trees out here. A good portion of them are ash trees, which pretty soon I'm going to have access to a vehicle that I can get all the way out here to the campsite, out here to the property that I do this. And back in the woods, I'm going to try to get a trail cut. And once I have access to get back here with four-wheel drive, then I'm going to start cleaning out the woods. You never know. I got a lot of land to use, so I could start building more big-time things at that point if I really wanted to. But I probably won't want to, honestly, because I love it simple, small, just like this. A little shelter, a little roof to be under, cook some food. A couple little creeks flowing through it. It's really not very remote at all. So you guys will hear the occasional planes, trains, and automobiles. But, man, to have a little spot like this to come out and cook food and enjoy nature, enjoy the outdoors is priceless. Even if you got to deal with a little traffic here and there. Got to use my kuksa for the first time today. Soul of Siberia, thank you so much. I'm going to put a link in the description to his Instagram page. If you guys aren't on Instagram, come check me out. Come look at my stuff. See if there's anything I'm posting you like. Usually I just take my videos and edit them down and put screenshots and stuff up. I like Instagram. It's pretty cool. But Soul of Siberia, he's got an amazing gallery of all the different carving kuksas he's put together. This thing is amazing. I honestly don't want to muck it up out here in the woods. I want to put it on display down back at my house. So beautiful. Beautiful work. So thank you. Thank you very much. Oh, man. Well, guys, I think that about does it for me today. I'm going to sit out here and enjoy the weather for a little bit longer. Probably clean up the camp a little bit. Cut down some dead standing trees. Maybe make a firewood pile for my next video. I appreciate you guys, really do. Thank you guys that are watching the videos and commenting and all that stuff. I have had a little bit of a break in work, which is nice, so now I can get these videos out, engage with you guys a little bit more. It's pretty much the best part, making friends online. All right, guys, cheers. Hope you guys have a good weekend, good week, and a good Christmas coming up. Till next time, Scrambled-o, signing out from the camp.